If you apply for a credit card and you get rejected, what should you do? Should you apply again? Should you apply for a different credit card? Should you apply a few weeks or months later on? What should you really do? Ideally, you want to avoid being rejected, and I'll talk about that in this video as well. But more importantly, in this video, I'll be focusing on the most important things to do if you ever get denied for a credit card. And getting denied for a credit card is really common. So if you've ever been rejected, this will be helpful. And even if you've never been rejected for a credit card before, then this video should still be helpful in the event that happens to you one day. Also, even if you get rejected, there are still ways that you can go about getting that very same credit card without reapplying. And I'll talk about that in this video as well. Now, before I go over the important steps to take, I want you guys to comment and let me know this. Have you ever been denied for a credit card before? And if you have been, what did you do afterwards? Comment down below and let me know. Also, if you're new to the channel and this is the first time that you're seeing me or first time that you're watching one of my videos, my name is Ian. And even if it's not the first time, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. I'll really appreciate it. And that's how these videos get recommended to more people. And also consider subscribing to this channel, and this will allow you to get the updates every day when I post a new video here. And yes, you heard that right. I post a new video here every single day on YouTube. So if you want to get daily content on personal finance topics, be sure to turn on all notifications for this channel. Now, this video is for you if you have good or fair credit, or if you have had bad credit, but it's now good or fair. If you have a really, really bad credit and a lot of recent missed payments, you owe a lot on other credit cards, then I would recommend that you work on fixing your credit first, because there's no magic trick to doing that. However, I have videos here on how to improve your credit quickly, so check those out if that's you. But the main reason why you may get rejected for a credit card, and these are usually one of three reasons. First, you don't have any credit history, meaning you've never had a credit card before and you don't have a credit score. Secondly, you don't qualify for the credit card that you want or you're applying for. And thirdly, you have really, really bad credit, or something in your credit report doesn't sit well with the credit card company. Now, it could be several recent late payments on other credit cards, or recent bankruptcies, or defaulting on car notes, or something of the sort. So now that we all know the three main reasons to getting rejected, let's look at what we can do about each and how we can go about fixing these before we actually apply as well. So the first one is not enough credit history. So if you've never had credit before, then chances are you're going to be denied because the credit card company won't be able to determine how much risk it will be for them to give you credit. So first, you want to establish some credit history. And even if you already have started, it takes time for this to reflect at all three credit bureaus. So start working on your credit and give it at least 6 months before you try to apply for any new credit cards. Now, when you're trying to establish credit for the first time, there are two main easy ways to go about it. The first way is to become an authorized user on someone else's credit card. The second way, which I recommend, is to get yourself a secured credit card, such as the Discover Secured. And for this credit card, they don't use your credit score to approve you. I also have a video about that credit card in detail and why I think it's the best, and I'll leave links to these at the end of this video. So establish some credit before you apply for any credit card, and that fixes your issue if that was the reason you were being rejected. Another point to make here is that there can be errors on your credit report, like a wrong address or street number, and so you get denied not because you don't have credit history, but because of the wrong information. And all three credit bureaus offer free credit reports once per year, so you should request these reports every year and look at your credit report to see if there's any incorrect information that needs to be corrected. The second reason is not qualifying for the credit card that you are applying for. So this could be because you're trying to get, let's say, one of the more prestigious travel rewards credit cards that requires you to have a certain credit score, like a 740 and over, and also a certain amount of money, like 75K and over per year in income. And these are requirements set by the credit card companies, so there's no way to go around this, but sometimes you get denied because the algorithm just doesn't like you. Credit card companies don't look at your credit report, or at least a real human doesn't. An algorithm makes the decision on if you're approved or not. So if you think you qualify, but you're denied, then a simple phone call to the credit card company can resolve this. You'll be able to get a real human to review the application, and they can either appeal and approve you for the credit card or explain why you were denied. And this also goes for increasing your credit line as well. A couple months ago, I requested a credit line increase from my Discover card, and I was denied, and I couldn't think of a reason why I would be denied. So I called and they were able to approve it, and I got the increase. Now, if you don't qualify for the credit card, then you need to work on the areas that make you ineligible. So if it's your income, then you need to earn more, or if you have a 710 and you need a 740, then you need to work on your credit score. Again, you can find this out before you apply for the credit card, and this way you can avoid being denied in the very first place. Third reason why you may get rejected is because your credit report looks very bad. However, contrary to what many people believe, credit card companies actually want to approve you for credit cards. That's how they make money, and if you don't go into debt, then they don't make any money. So again, if you want a credit card, start fixing your credit. Start making on-time payments, don't go over your credit limit. Just try to be responsible with it. And again, if you call and speak to a real human and you explain to them that you want the credit card and you are fixing your credit, chances are they will approve you because that's what their job is, to approve as many possible people and hope that they don't pay their credit card bill on time so they can charge you even more interest. Now, if you apply, you would get denied again because the algorithm is going to see bankruptcy and say denied. It's going to see late payments and say denied. It's going to see a low credit score and it's going to say denied. So your best bet is to call for a manual review. Now, everything that I've just mentioned here can be done before you actually apply for a credit card. And if you ask me, I'll tell you that you should never get denied for a credit card because you should know the card you want and the requirements and not apply unless you think you have a very good chance of being approved. Also, remember, when you apply for new credit, your credit score goes down. So the last thing you want is to apply for a credit card and lose a couple points and then end up getting denied. So for example, if you have no credit history or you have a very bad credit score, then you shouldn't apply for a Chase credit card. You'll be denied. Instead, apply for a secured credit card that will approve you and then try to repair your credit. If you just blindly apply for these credit cards and leave it up to luck, then chances are you will get denied a lot. Again, credit card companies want to approve you because that's how they make money. So if you know the minimum credit score required to get the card and the income that you need to make, then the chances of you getting denied will be very slim. I hope this video helps and I hope you guys found this very helpful. And if you'd like to see more videos just like this one, be sure to give this video a thumbs up as that's the way these videos get recommended to more people and I'll really, really appreciate it. Also guys, giving this video a thumbs up or a like is completely free. Also, don't forget to check out some of my other videos here, more on credit cards, banking apps, savings accounts, investments, ways to make money, and much more. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so, and be sure to turn on all notifications for this channel, as that's the only way you'll be able to get the updates of when I post new videos here, and I'll be posting a new video here on YouTube every single day. And remember, I'm also leaving a couple links down below to free stuff and free cashback offers, so be sure to check all the links down below in the description for all kinds of free stuff. Now, if you haven't already seen my other videos on credit cards and how to improve your credit, then I'll leave a link to my playlist here and I have several videos on credit cards and improving your credit. If you aren't investing as of yet, be sure to check out Webull, and I've left the link down below to Webull, and if you sign up using the link, you'll receive a free stock or two free stocks, which can be valid at up to $1,600. If you like the stocks, you get to keep them because they're free. If you don't like them, you can sell them and keep the cash, or you can use that money to get other stocks that you'd prefer to invest in. Once again, guys, I hope this video was very helpful. All the best with your credit, and I hope to see you guys tomorrow.